Small steps these after 3 months of being in a state of limbo. The UN Security Council finally seems to have woken up to the coronavirus reality. The pandemic now seems to fit the geopolitical scope of this body. How exactly? What has changed now? The answer is simple. China is no longer calling the shots. The Dominican Republic is the new chair of the United Nations Security Council. It's a rotating presidency. It changes every month. So the Dominican Republic took charge last week, and within days there has been some progress. 9 elected members of the UNSC have written to the body's president. They want a meeting on the quote-unquote peace and security impacts of COVID-19. Jose Singer, the special envoy from the Dominican Republic, has given the nod. The meeting is apparently taking shape. It may happen before this weekend's. Even the UN Security General, Secretary General, will be finally briefing the Council on the pandemic. Listen to this.
When you plan to brief the Security Council on COVID-19?
I've just received an invitation from the President of the Security Council at the request of a number of member states to brief the Council, which I will do, next week.
Very well, but beyond the optics of meetings and briefings, what the world needs right now, and is badly hoping for, if I may add, is a UNSC resolution. A council resolution would be binding on all UN member states. It would help mobilize resources on war footing. So will there be a resolution? We can't say for sure. The UNSC chair wants the meeting to take place first and see how the events play out. But there are 2 draft resolutions currently in circulation, one among the permanent members, the second among the non-permanent states. The Security Council may wish to take up one of them. The most compelling is the one prepared by Estonia. This resolution highlights the growing concerns about the unprecedented impact of the coronavirus outbreak. This resolution calls for full transparency over the pandemic. A clear reference to the charges that China is hiding vital information about the origins of the virus. Remember, this very same proposal was rejected by Beijing last month. Can China still block it? Yes, it can. Remember, China is a permanent member. It holds the veto power. A veto can scotch any resolution. What's worse, China has backers, Russia. Russia is expected to support China like it did last month. The US is yet to take a stand and, more importantly, stick to it. Remember, Donald Trump started by calling it a Chinese virus. Then he had a phone call with President Xi Jinping of China and he praised China's efforts. We don't know what his thoughts are on China this week. We'll keep you posted. Back to the Security Council, the 2 other permanent members are France and the United Kingdom. Both nations badly hit by the Wuhan virus, but they haven't censured China yet. The UNSC meet should be a good opportunity to pin responsibility. This is a story to watch out for this week.